everybody, I'm TechMaster, and welcome to the first episode of Breeza's Research Facility. And for people who watched the other first episode, you might be wondering why I'm doing this. Well, you know, stuff happens in life, and, you know, something, you know, whatever. I don't really want to talk about it today. Anyway, yep, this is episode one. Please, do not remember the last first episode. This is too complicated to tell you. Anyway, yeah, this is the new start of Breeza's Research Facility. Right. So, yeah. I double-checked it, and it seems to be fine for me to record. Yeah. So, Breeza's Research Facility main spawn. Awesome. We have two signs right here. Op me 10 times. To get the operator position of this server. You know, sometimes, you know, people, when we bump the Planet Minecraft thread, people come on and say, I'm from Planet Minecraft, and we just tell them to do that. And someone's stupid enough to actually do op me 10 times, and we just ban them. Ban them from the server, because they're no use. Anyway, we are here with the owners here at spawn, main spawn, Breeza and Jimbo, and all the staff members here, chat mods, we call them researchers. So, this server is established 6 days ago, and we do have a great player base at the moment, and the recording time is 4:10 p.m., which means it's 4 a.m. in the United States, and it is really damn cool to have this awesome player base that is dedicated, and we must thank Mark for banning people in their TeamSpeak so that we get a better player base. Anyway, if you're new, click this. If you're not new and you're a normal player, click this sign to go to your spawn. Your era's spawn. And I haven't actually introduced this. So basically the server has... Crap, I forgot to get creative mode. Basically, you start off a test subject where we require you to accept the terms of service, which you have to read or you don't read, your choice, but you must accept it. You know, just some issues that we need to sort about that we couldn't include in the rules. Also, be sure to check out our rules at our website. We have a full list of rules there for you to check out. Alright, so basically after you click that sign, you enter caveman. It costs 12,000 to enter Egyptian, and 40,000 to blah blah blah, all these crap you need to read. And all the basic commands, we have the Pioneer is a free rank, and also we're gonna attempt to create a prestige mode, which I will talk about in a later episode. Anyway, let's go to the caveman spawn. And yeah, this is his caveman, hand-built by Breeza and Jimbo. Holy crap, this is like man-made cave. Holy crap. Anyway, it's awesome. It's the best block I've seen on the server. And basically, spawn right here, and there's a stone mine. There's a tree farm right here, a stone mine there. The gold blocks and that money sign is obviously the shop. And we have bank chests right here. To the left. There's a big chest. It's pixel art. It looks like a chest, doesn't it? And we have a fishing pond that nobody actually uses. I don't even know why they exist. But yeah, this is caveman. So, rightio. I'm also going to show you the voter caveman, which you can access via this friggin' sign. And if I warp to Sun Lab, you guys can't do this, you must use... What the f... Oh my god... Hex, user hkminegod, group, add... No, hex group... No, effects user hkminegod. You add voters. There we go. And let's vote. Oh my god! Ugh. How much money do I have? $0.69. God damn it. Eco, give hkminegod. And let's spend it on here. I hope I'm not abusing or something. But whoops. Anyway. Caveman! Sun Lab! Basically, Sun Lab is the fully non-PvP facility called, originally called the Voter Facility, if you know. And we have this awesome mine right here down this crater, and we have, like, the whole area as a tree farm. If you follow the gold blocks, you'll find the shop, and if you follow the diamond blocks, obviously you'll find the chest area, I think. I need to go. Yep, the chest area right here. Oh, I forgot to tell you, we have furnaces and free ender chests. Not friggin' like KDC where you need to friggin' donate to get ender chests. Bullshit. Anyway, we have friggin' fishing pond right here, open. And yeah, that's basically all you need to know for caveman. And be sure to check on your money, which can be accessed through /Starzy and /Markillion. If you played KDC before, you perhaps will know what I'm talking about. Anyway, that's all you need to know about caveman after you have the enough money to rank up, which is 12k, you can do /rank up to rank yourself up. I'm an engineer, so I can't do that. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed episode 1, and I hope to see you next time. Goodbye.